CX0 and FVR-H or L 200 to 380 compressors electrical cable connections. Tools: ratchet or screw gun, a 17mm socket, a 19mm socket, torque wrench, small slotted screwdriver, small Phillips screwdriver, normal Phillips screwdriver, pliers. Personal protective equipment: safety helmet, protective glasses, protective gloves, safety shoes. Attention! Keep and read the instruction manual carefully and always respect the safety warnings indicated. Attention! This video shows a CX0 compressor. Compressor label check. Carefully read the label on the compressor to size the components of the electrical panel. Pay attention to the type of motor indicated and the volt, MRA and LRA values given. Check of the supply status. Using a Phillips screwdriver or a screw gun, open the junction box and check its contents. In this case, we find spare gasket kit, temperature probe, vibration damper support kit, nut and washer kit for electrical connection, Kriwan module with terminal block, connectors for solenoid valves. Open the various kits containing inside the junction box and place the contents in an orderly manner in order to make a precise and fast electrical connection. How to make the PWS electrical connection on CX0 and FVR-H or L compressors from 200 to 380 cubic meters per hour. Remove one or more of the caps on the junction box and insert one or more cable glands. Remove the Kriwan connection cables from pins 7, 8 and 9. Thread the earth cable through one of the two previously positioned cable glands and proceed with the wiring. Insert the 10mm washer on the earth pin, position the earth cable and then the second 10mm washer. Insert the 10mm nut and secure everything using a ratchet with a 17mm socket. Then check that it's all tight using a torque wrench set to 20 Nm. The electrical terminal plate shows the numbers relating to each individual pin, which can be used as a legend to position the power cables. Insert the first three power cables in one of the two cable glands and position them on the pins 1, 2 and 3. Insert the other three power cables in the second cable gland in which the earth cable was inserted and position them on the three pins 7, 8 and 9. Tick! It's advisable to use power cables in the three different colors so that the positions of the cables match, inserting black with black, brown with brown and gray with gray. This will allow easier visual wiring. Take the three Kriwan connection cables and insert the black cable on pin 7, the brown cable on pin 8, and the blue cable on pin 9. Take 6 washers and place them on each pin. Take 6 nuts and place them on each pin. Secure everything using a ratchet with a 19mm socket, then check the tightness of the nuts using a torque wrench set to 30Nm. Close the junction box by tightening all the screws of the cover with a Phillips screwdriver or a screw gun. How to make the dull electrical connection on CX0 and FVR-H or L compressors from 200 to 380 cubic meters per hour. Remove the cap on the junction box and insert the cable gland. Remove the Kriwan connection cables from pins 7, 8 and 9. Thread the earth cable and proceed with the wiring. Insert the 10mm washer on the earth pin. Position the earth cable. And then the second 10mm washer. Insert the 10mm nut. And secure everything using a ratchet with a 17mm socket. Then check that it is all tight using a torque wrench set to 20Nm. The electrical terminal plate shows the letters and numbers relating to each individual pin, which can be used as a legend to position the electrical connection bars and power. Take the optional kit containing the three bars for the dull connection and position them in such a way as to pair the pins as follows: 1 with 7, 2 with 8, and finally 3 with 9. Insert the three power cables in the previously positioned cable gland and position them on pins 1, 2, and 3. Or alternatively on pins 7, 8 and 9. Take the three Kriwan connection cables and insert the black cable on pin 7. The brown cable on pin 8 and the blue cable on pin 9. Take 6 washers and place them on each pin. Take 6 nuts and place them on the washers. Secure everything using a ratchet with a 19mm socket, then check the tightness of the nuts using a torque wrench set to 30Nm. Close the junction box by tightening all the screws of the cover with a Phillips screwdriver or a screw gun. Temperature probe wiring for CX0 and FVR-H L compressors from 200 to 380 cubic meters per hour. First of all, remove the protective cap from the temperature probe. Take the temperature probe cable and make sure that the jack is correctly positioned with respect to the probe on the compressor. Insert the cable into the appropriate slot, tightening the ring nut by hand. Remove one of the caps on the junction box and position the cable gland with its gasket, securing it carefully. Take the other end of the cable and insert it into the cable gland previously positioned on the junction box, approaching the terminal block. Using a small slotted screwdriver, slightly unscrew the screws on inlets 11 and 12 of the terminal block. Insert the cables and tighten the two screws again. Level switch installation on CX0 and FVR-H or L compressors from 200 to 380 cubic meters per hour. Remove the protective cap from the level switch prism. Take the oil level sensor kit and place it on the level switch prism, tightening the ring nut by hand. Remove one of the caps on the junction box and insert the appropriate cable gland. Then insert the level switch cable inside it. Using a slotted screwdriver, slightly loosen the screws on inlets 1, 2, 7, 8, and 9. Insert the blue cable into inlet 1. The brown cable into inlet 2. The gray cable into inlet 7. The pink cable into inlet 8. And finally, the orange cable into inlet 9. Carefully tighten all the screws to secure the cables and complete the wiring. Finally, tighten the cable gland, fastening ring nut completely to secure everything. Flow switch wiring on CX0 and FVR-H or L compressors from 200 to 380 cubic meters per hour. First of all, take a 2-core cable and connect the connector to the flow switch, gently tightening the screw with a Phillips screwdriver. Remove the cap from one of the holes on the junction box. Insert the cable gland and the 2-core cable and secure everything with the ring nut. Using a slotted screwdriver, slightly unscrew the screws on the terminal block at inlets 3 and 4. Insert the two cables for the flow switch and tighten the screws again to secure everything. Finally, tighten the cable gland fastening ring nut completely to secure everything. How to electrically connect Kriwan Diagnose on CX0 compressors? Remove the Kriwan INT69FRY device supplied as standard in the junction box of the CX series compressors and replace it with the optional Kriwan Diagnose device, keeping all the cables. Insert the brown cable into inlet L and the blue cable into inlet N. Take the three-phase sequence control cables connected to the circuit board and, using a pair of pliers, insert the black cable into inlet L1 the brown cable into inlet 2 and finally the blue cable into inlet L3. At this point, take the previously removed thermistor cables and insert them, with the help of a slotted screwdriver, into inlets 1 and 2 of the Kriwan Diagnose device. Again using the pliers, connect the other end of the thermistor cables on the circuit board to pins T1 and T2. Attention! The two thermistor cables must be connected to pins T1 and T2. They cannot be connected to pins T3 and T4. Remove the resistor on the Kriwan Diagnose device at outlets 3 and 4. And insert the two temperature probe cables in their place, in order to carry out the wiring. To proceed with the wiring of the flow switch, remove the jumper on the Kriwan Diagnose device from inlets 9 and 10 and using the two slotted screwdrivers, insert the two flow switch cables in its place. Finally, proceed with the wiring of the level switch. First of all, using a slotted screwdriver, slightly unscrew the screws of the terminal block at inlets 3 and 4. Insert the blue cable into inlet 3 and the brown cable into inlet 4. Tighten the two screws to secure everything. Then, on the Kriwan Diagnose device, remove the jumper from inlets 5 and 6. Connect the orange cable at inlet 5 and the grey one at inlet 6. To complete the wiring of the flow switch, connect the pink cable to an alarm bulb. If you like this video, subscribe to the channel and discover all Frascold's video trainings. Frascold, blue is better.